and welcome back to another Rock CTM Test World. Today we're going to discuss a little bit about loot mobs. So, traditionally how loot mobs are done is we have some mob, like this little guy right here. Hey guy. And upon killing them, they drop some random assortment of loot, such as cobblestone or potions, food, maybe some resources and such. Now, this is typically how loot mobs are done nowadays in 1.7 and prior versions of Minecraft because of the limitations on how stuff can be added to the mob. So, typically, the mob can only have five unique drops. The head slot, body, pants, boots, and the weapon slot. So, in general, you're only allowed five unique drops off of a given custom loot mob. Now, that's a little bit of too much. That's a little too limiting for us. So, today we're going to move on, segue our way over to Loot Mobs 2.0, or as I've dubbed them. So, with the recently, or somewhat recently, in the 1.8 snapshots, was introduced the ability to pick, click, tile entities, giving them NVT data. So as you see, we pick click this chest that has some really nice gear in it, and we can place it. And we have all the same gear in each chest. Now, we're not specifically limited to just picking it up in our inventory. We can also give mobs these tile entities with NVT data as well. So for example, we have this lovely chest right here. Let's say we had a zombie that dropped that fat loot. Oh. But we're not limited to just chest. We can also do things such as furnaces. So for example, this is a cooking on the go furnace. So this is a furnace that provides the player with 8 coal already, allowing them to just plop it down, put some food or metals or whatnot into it, and cook it and go on their way. Another example of a mob is this little guy right here. Now, unfortunately, brewing stands do not display on zombie heads, so unfortunately you won't get to see it on the mob. However, he does have a potion prep station. So if we prep this down, you can see we already have awkward potions in here. We can set different damage values on the potion. We can set quantities and such. And so this would be an example of just a quick potion stand that already has the awkward potions created. So for example, if you don't want to give the player nether wards, but however you want to give them potions, you can give them a little quick potion stand with the awkward potions and let them cook what they want, and then, you know, they can move on from there. But one really, really nice thing about the whole system is that you can have tile entities with NBT data inside, such as this. However, you can have tile entities with NBT data of other tile entities which have NBT data in them as well. So, for example, we have this zombie fella right here that drops a chest called All-in-One. Now, if we open this all-in-one chest, we have a fat loot, a cooking on the go, and a potion prep station, which we can plop down right here, here, and here. And as you can see in each one, we have the loot that was in each respected one. So, in theory, you could nest multiple chests inside chest, essentially giving unlimited drops. You have a near infinite amount of unique drops that you can have a single mob drop, which is overall a lot cooler than 5 drops. So without going too deep into the unique and with tile entities inside of tile entities, if with just one chest, for example, in each slot, that gives you an incredible amount of space. Let's see, there's 27 slots in each chest, a single chest times 5 slots. It gives you 135 unique items with just chests in each slot. And of course, with all for ones, you can have in near infinite until the game crashes. But that is Loot Mobs 2.0. I do see a lot of potential in this, and that it will give the player or give map makers the ability to give more than, you know, five custom loots per for loot mob. It also gives the map maker the ability to give, you know, special little things to help the player along, such as maybe, you know, stone isn't given by the map maker. However, stone and maybe coal, you're in a maybe particular area early in the map. You haven't received stone or coal yet. The map maker can have some mobs that drop some of this, or you're in an area that doesn't have potion ingredients, or not potion ingredients, but nether warts yet. You can give these out. Just a little bit of examples of what you can do. So I'd be interested to see what you guys come up with as map makers, and I hope to see this in future maps as it does have a lot of possibilities. So, as always, if you have any comments, questions, suggestions, or feedback, feel free to leave a comment in the comment section down below. As always, this is Rock, and I'll catch you guys next time. Bye!